Hello, PlayStation planners, players, and pure geniuses. Welcome back to the channel. Welcome to Copen City. This is a city that I built just kind of on my spare time. I used a lot of it for ideas on other cities, and boy, it just turned out great. Everybody that's built a city on this map has just had some phenomenal creations, and I wanted to get in on that mix. This map is probably one of the best Cities Skylines 1 maps out there. Alright, so I'm going to do a little bit of narrating in-game here. So, this city was designed to have this main road you can see right up the middle of the screen here to basically feed from the interstate into the heart of town. But the way that it was designed, I used these one-way, three-lane roads with the bike paths on them. Which, it's awesome, but it makes traffic, the speed limit, very slow. And since the speed limit is very slow, it gets a lot of bicycle traffic, but there's not a lot of car traffic. Not like there should be for how dense I planned on this roadway being. One could say that was really good road layout planning on my part, that it's not overflowing with traffic. But here's the problem. Is there's these other highways, like this highway here, leads around the edge of town. Now, the idea of this highway is an industrial highway. It's supposed to hit all of my major industries. It goes right by the college here and comes down and hits my farming industry. And then it sweeps on over down to my energy and water and garbage area and ends at my cargo harbor. So it's very important for my freight and my cargo, but I see a lot of cars that are not industry related that are using this highway to get around. I know I'm not going to keep them all off of here, but those are all vehicles that could be going through the heart of town right now, and instead they're plugging up this cargo highway. The other end is over here, where we have just this mass flow of traffic flowing down this six-lane highway that goes along the river, or this six-lane arterial road that flows along the river and into downtown here. Now, this is going to naturally have a lot of traffic on it. It's planned that way. But I feel like a lot of people are using these other two areas to get it around town rather than going through the heart of town as intended. So today I'm going to try and turn that into an elevated freeway that cuts through all of these intersections here, and then I'm going to turn the monorail, or the tram line in the middle, into a six-lane road to handle all of the neighborhood traffic. So this elevated highway is going to have two interchanges, one at this roundabout and one at this roundabout. Other than that, it's going to bypass all of this stuff to hopefully get some of this traffic from the heart of town here, where we have all of our tourism, our downtown, our travel hubs, and just try and make this direct connection more relevant than having to go all the way that way or all the way around town that way. So, let's dive to work.
Yeah.
Now we're just putting in the last couple of details here, making this place a part of the city again. I think we've had it on pause long enough. Lots of big changes to the city. Sometimes making changes like this to your city can be kind of intimidating. You spend so much time building up your city and its infrastructure that sometimes tapping into it or making big changes like this can be near devastating for your cities. But if you plan it right, and I can't say it was top of my agenda to know that I might put a freeway here, but I try to make my builds as modular as I can, especially if I'm planning on busy roads or busy areas. I try to leave some room around them, so that way, if I do have to make changes like this or add some sort of transit or whatever the case may be, it's as simple as upgrading a road, elevating a road, putting in a freeway, or adding in some kind of transit with maybe tracks or something alongside the road. So it's kind of my game strategy. It helps when I'm trying to make these bigger cities, especially, to sort of plan ahead and know that at some point I'm going to have to upgrade, no matter how future-proof it I make. So I hope you guys are enjoying these videos. I hope you're enjoying the content that we're bringing out at Mad Battery Productions. Like I always say, it's a ton of fun. It really is. It's going to continue to be a ton of fun. And keep checking back in to see more of the content. I'm going to wrap up the rest of this build, and you guys keep playing, PlayStation players.